Hi, I'm Bud. Welcome to Kimba's Kingdom, the home of everything Kimba the White Lion. On this channel, I'm hoping to connect with fellow Kimba fans like you. So if there's something you'd like to see more of, or less of, let me know in the comments. I want to make the best videos I can for you guys. Here it is, part 2. If you haven't seen part 1 of this video, click here to watch it first so that this video makes sense. Or don't, I guess. I'm not your dad. Tomita's choice of instruments for the soundtrack gives it a very distinct and instantly recognisable style, and also reflects the central ideas and setting of the series. Throughout the soundtrack, he uses a soft and gentle string section, often combined with a mysterious and magical sounding choir, a loud and bold brass section which usually dominates the tracks, a wide variety of percussion instruments, both tuned and untuned, and he sprinkles in an occasional bit of harmonica, flute, or guitar as well. Now let's break that all down. The choice of brass instruments as the loud, dominant section of the orchestra works on a number of levels. For a start, brass instruments are very adaptable. You can use them to play fun or menacing jazzy pieces, epic heroic pieces, and deeply impactful emotional chords. And Kimba uses them for all three. Using brass instruments as a common thread across the whole soundtrack gives it a very consistent style, despite the very wide range of emotions and ideas it has to explore. Brass instruments are also the newest addition to the classical orchestra. They became commonplace due to the Industrial Revolution. This modernity makes them a symbol of progress, a symbol of civilization. The powerful loudness of the brass section is a symbol of the power of technology and machinery. What better choice could there possibly be for a series about the main protagonist bringing civilization to his jungle than the very category of instruments that symbolizes civilization? It's the perfect choice. But what about the strings and the choir? Well, for a start, those sections allow Tomita to score for quieter, more delicate moments in the story, where a brass section would be too in-your-face and melodramatic. And they also add some texture and depth to the brass section when it is playing. But the strings also represent how Kimba's brand of civilization is not all cold and industrial. Typically made of wood and hair, and the type of instrument that sounds most similar to the human voice in terms of timbre, strings are traditionally seen as organic and natural, a symbol of life, a symbol of the natural. While the loud, dominant brass section shows how Kimba is bringing progress and modernity to the jungle, The string section conveys how Kimba isn't forgetting that he's leading a kingdom of creatures, not a kingdom of machines. It reflects the empathy he shows when, on multiple occasions, he's willing to bring everything he's been working on to a halt just to protect a single animal. It shows how, while on the surface he's all about progress and moving forward, deep down he's acting out of compassion and a very natural, organic love for all his citizens and for all animals. The choir has a similar effect because, as mentioned earlier, strings sound a lot like the human voice, but it also adds this air of mystery as well, evoking the same sense of mysticism and the supernatural that Holst evokes in Neptune, his brilliantly gentle conclusion to The Planets. The percussion section, unusually varied and loud for an orchestral soundtrack, is also highly meaningful. The most obvious thing it does is evoke the location of Africa. African music is characterized by elaborate and complex percussion. For tens of thousands of years, different cultures across Africa have developed their own unique interpretations of how percussion can be used in intricate ways. And as a series set in Africa, Kimba the White Lion was basically obliged to respect this tradition and incorporate percussion as a major element in its own musical style. There's also more to the percussion section than just evoking Africa. Often the first instrument we'll give a child to play will be some kind of percussion. A toy xylophone, maracas, a triangle. So percussion symbolizes learning and curiosity. It evokes a sense of childlike wonder. By emphasizing the percussion section so heavily, Tomita shows the audience how the animals of Kimba's jungle are just starting out. Like a child, they're new to civilization, and they have a long road ahead of them. But they're filled with a childlike optimism and playfulness, just like a child playing his first toy xylophone. And like string sections, percussion also sounds organic, especially wooden percussion instruments which are used very heavily in the Kimba soundtrack. So it again reminds us that the citizens of Kimba's jungle are organic creatures. They're inseparably tied to nature. No matter how far they go down the path of civilization, they will never lose the connection to the jungle, the rivers and the sky that makes them animals in the first place. And it acts as a bit of a subtle reminder to us humans to never lose that connection either. a reminder not to get so carried away with our ability to make machines that we forget our deep connection to nature and biology, something more beautiful and intricate than any machine could ever be. I could go on, but I think you get the point. The instrumentation of your soundtrack requires deep thought. There has to be a reason why a particular instrument is louder than another. There has to be a reason why some instruments are there and some aren't. Every instrument you add to the track is a deliberate choice, and it means something. So when you're composing your TV soundtrack, make sure you know what it means. The instrumentation of your soundtrack is just as essential to conveying your characters, themes, and the spirit of your series as any of the writing or animation. The soundtrack is an integral part of your work and should be inseparable from it. And Kimba the White Lion shows that brilliantly. Every little choice Tomita made with the instrumentation meant something. He thought carefully about every single decision, and the sum of all those little details was something truly beautiful and moving. So, to recap, in your own TV soundtrack, make sure to make use of leitmotifs to represent each of your main characters, settings, and main concepts. And remember that you don't have to play the entire leitmotif on its own every time you want to use it. You can use just a couple of notes, or you can blur it together with other leitmotifs, or blur it into a totally new melody to achieve a more subtle, but perhaps even deeper, emotional effect, the same way Tomita does. Also, consider using techniques like reverb to give your music a sense of place and atmosphere, to really make your audience feel like they're there in the scenes. And also make sure to think carefully about your instrumentation. Make every choice count. Make the relative volume and importance of every instrument in the overall mix mean something, to reach your audience on a deeper, more meaningful level. If you found this analysis interesting, let me know, because I'd love to revisit the soundtrack and talk about the harmonies, melodies, and rhythms in the future. I'll just need to find someone who can help me out with understanding those things, because my own knowledge of the topic is quite limited. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this and found it helpful nonetheless. It was one of my favourite videos to make. I adore the soundtrack, in case you couldn't tell. That's all for now, fellow animals. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you won't miss a thing. If there's something Kimba related you'd like to see a video about, leave a comment. I'd love to hear your suggestions. I might look ferocious, but I don't bite, promise.